Yeah, T6 somehow found a way to bump into the corner. What? What's up everybody, Tempest is here, and today we're gonna be playing Farming Simulator 15. Yes, in this episode, I don't think anything super duper important is gonna happen, though we're gonna have fun, we're gonna have our share of fun as usual. So, my plans for today are gonna be, first thing I wanna do is I wanna set up this harvester on another field. We, by the way, almost completed harvesting all our fields, and by almost I mean 70%. We still need to collect field number 6, I think. Oh, and field number... Yeah, what field is that, by the way? That's field number 2, and I think I'm gonna start with that, or I should start with this one here. That's a bit smaller. Where is it? Field number 5. Should I clean it up first? Nope, I'm gonna skip it for now. I just wanna go and start harvesting bigger fields first. Let's start with field number 6. Looks like a decent candidate for today's harvesting. Well, this farm actually is starting to look better. We have decent amount of funds to start thinking about investing into cattle. Well, let's see, open the gate. Yes. What I want to do is I want to buy myself a couple of pigs, a couple of beef, and start raising them, as this farm is humongous. As you can see, we've got a bunch of fields. We don't need to worry about it at all. The one thing we need to worry about, though, is bigger equipment, like bigger harvesters or bigger tractors, more powerful tractors, front loaders, and that kind of stuff. On the bright side, we have, what do we have? We have the balers. Two of them, by the way, and in order to start feeding them, the only thing we need is actually, I think we even have windrower on this farm, so we will be needing just tether, and that's it. Oh, actually, yeah, we will be needing to harvest our grass somehow, so mowers is the priority right now. That is the thing I want to do. Basically, we need around 60,000 for that, but I don't think it's going to be a problem for us. We can either sell our crops, which we have plenty of, or we could, what could we do? We could just take a loan, that's another option. So let's just start this harvester here. Nothing else to do. It's gonna do usual job, nothing special. It's gonna do just perfectly fine. So we will be unloading this little T4, T6, damn it. Yeah, we'll be unloading T6. And then what I wanna do is I want to think about selling crops in this episode, or just start mowing straight away. You know what I'm thinking that I'm gonna start mowing in this episode. We need to get into that cattle production ASAP. We will invest the rest of our money into buying those little munchkins and pigs and all that kind of stuff. Let's go ahead and unload our barley, which we have plenty of, by the way, more than 150,000 liters. I'm planning to sell it, but it would be perfect if we could sell it on great demand. Also, I don't know if I'm able to wait for it. We are in big trouble right now on this farm. Big trouble. Although it looks much better than it used to. Alrighty, let's see. By the way, look at that. We've got windrower. We can sell this. We don't need it. It's only 6 meters wide. I don't see any point in having this when you have your cedar. Maybe there is a point when we are gonna be sowing potatoes and sugar beet. Interesting. Maybe I will keep it. There is a point always. But other than that, we only need windrower. Damn it! There is a windrower in here. We only need how is it called? Damn it. Tether. We need tether. And what else? That's it, I think. We are set to harvest our grass. And of course, I'm always forgetting about mowers, but we have those. We are gonna buy those as a priority right now. So yeah, this one is harvesting just fine. You know what I should have done? I think I should have started it from the other way around, and there is an option to do that with auto harvester. Let's try it, maybe that is gonna work. I wanna start harvesting it the other way around. Maybe it's gonna work, maybe it's not gonna work. Who knows? Although we've already started, damn it. Alright, I'll let it just proceed with one turn, and then we'll see what's gonna happen, just like so. This one is an interesting topic. I thought to sell it, and I think I'm gonna do it. We're gonna sell this wood chipper, because we are not gonna be using it anymore. It's just a waste of time. For me personally, I feel like it's a waste of time. Maybe you're doing much better than I do with this wood chipper, but for me, it's just a lot of struggles. A lot of struggles, and I don't want to proceed doing that. Oh my gosh. Woods, stop. Stop torturing me, please. Guys, I've had enough of torture. Please release me. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. I'm glad you understand my struggles. And yeah, there is an exit over here. I've recently discovered it. I think it's over here, right? Yep, it's open over there. So we will be going straight ahead and selling our wood chipper, even though it looks gorgeous. I know it looks amazing. I love using it sometimes, but in general the whole experience was a bit of a torture for me, so I'm not planning on doing wood chipping in the nearest episode, unless we have that amazing truck or better equipment for it, like loaders or the one that can store wood chips right after it process them. That would be an amazing machinery to have. Your suggestions are welcome, guys. If you know anything cool, because I think I've showed you a couple of mods already, like Jen's wood crusher, for example, is an amazing one. It's got, and of course I'm driving on the wrong side of the road. It's got, OMG. Yeah, it's totally my fault. Sorry for that, mate. It's got the Scorpion King attached to the wood crusher, and it's got the trailer as well. How amazing is that? There it goes, the selling point. Unfortunately, we've got to say goodbye to our wood crusher, and we have nothing else to say. Thank you very much for your services. We've made 30,000 from it, so I think it should at least pay for itself after we sell it over here. Detach, let's go. So that we accidentally won't sell our case as well. Let's go and proceed to the selling point. Unfortunately, I have to sell you, mate. Maybe we will see another. We will see you another day. Sell vehicle directly. Yeah, we'll be getting 52,800 euros, which is not bad. Let's see for how much exactly did we purchase our wood crusher. Where is it? Forest equipment here, 88,000. So basically, yeah, we've lost around 30,000, which we actually made in the previous episode with the same wood crusher. So we did not waste any money. In general, we only wasted our time with it. But that's not big of a problem. We had our share of experience, so I think it is well worth it. Let's start this tractor on the other hand and start proceeding to the base, cause. Or just maybe not yet, I'll be parking it over here, just like so. And we'll see what we're gonna do with this body. Well, this one is full. I'll go ahead and help it unload. Here is an interesting point. Oh, it's not too far. But we will be needing to give it a couple of rounds to unload, at least one. So I'm thinking to start my harvester the other way around. So I will wait on one round right now, and I will be setting it up again, all over again, and we'll see how well it goes this time. Let's unload you, buddy. Let's go ahead and wait until it is fully unloaded, then we will give it time to proceed forward. Don't think it's gonna take us. Let's stop the tractor, by the way. Should take him long. I think I'm gonna do it manually from this point. Let us start the harvester and proceed manually just till the point where we started, and then I will be resetting it up, and we'll see how well it's gonna work from there. Hopefully it's gonna work just fine. Hopefully it will. And I'm so happy we've got so many fields to harvest. It's gonna help us out in the nearest future. As soon as we encounter great demand, all our problems are gonna be solved. Well, not all of our problems, but most of our problems on this farm are gonna be solved. And I'm eagerly waiting for that great demand, because I know how many things I can buy after selling everything we've collected so far. And you know what? This field, for some reason, looks very weird. And I think because I've collected it with coarse clay, that is why it's not as neat as this one. Maybe I should have used auto combine from the beginning. Auto combine is amazing when it comes to harvesting your fields. You will not regret setting it up. It is much better than the standard hire worker, because it's got an ability of circling around your field, and that solves all sorts of problems with the tight fields like this one. As you can see, the hedges aren't transparent, so if you are gonna hire an ordinary worker, it just won't work. He's gonna bump into everything. So I think that these kinds of fields, these kinds of maps, like our Coldborough Park farm, were made for manual work, I'd say, but programs like auto combine and coarse clay still allow you to automate this process. And let's see, the way I wanted to set it up is from here, and I'm just wondering if it is possible. Let's just try it out. If it is possible, then our coarse clay will not have any problems anymore. Let's see if it is. What about active side left? Tell me you're gonna work. Yes, it looks like it is gonna work. So the only thing you have to do is change your active side, and your active side is right, and it's gonna work just fine. All right, course play, you've got work to do. Let's start you. Oh my gosh, sorry for that. And let's start you from the most convenient point here, and I think it's gonna be somewhere over the rainbow. No, I'm kidding, not over the rainbow, somewhere here. Look at that, it looks so much better. It looks so much better. I'm loving it. And our course play is not gonna have any problem bumping into these stupid hedges. But the starting point is gonna be, of course, here. It is important to have a distance, of course, is very important. So starting point, hopefully I will not fail it, and let's do that. All right, the key in here is not to hurry. Very important not to hurry, and do it perfectly, because if we fail it, we're gonna have to start all over again. Thankfully it's not too far, so we can afford to start it all over again. And I like these values in here. Start at 85, I found it to be the most convenient spot. And drive on at 100, I could set it up to 95, something like that. Should be fine. Let's try 95, who knows. Alright, I know it doesn't look very cool when tractor is going through the field like that. Not very realistic, I don't enjoy it myself. But that's the only way you can set it up with coarse clay and do other things simultaneously. Look at that, isn't it perfect? Now that it approaches our harvester from the other side, from the other side of the field, it won't have any problems bumping into the hedges. Can you imagine? All problems solved by just starting your harvester from the other way around. Oh my gosh, how easy was that? And I thought about it in the previous episode, but then my harvester was halfway through the field, and I was like, all right, I'll try the next episode. And it looks like it is gonna work. I'm so happy. What the hell? How do we have 11,000 in the trailer? Ooh, I actually forgot to unload it as usual. But now that it is almost done, I have a chance to test and see how well our course is gonna work. As usual, usual stuff here, nothing special. But again, nothing special is gonna happen unless we make enough money. The most challenging part on any farm is to have enough. And this part over here, this little tree, is gonna be very, very tricky to go around. Hopefully my harvester won't have any problems, although I might have to readjust it a couple of times, or I might just as well destroy this little tree. And yeah, barley is the only thing we've got in abundance. We've got bunch of it. Let's see how much exactly do we have. Where is it? Yeah, we've got 160,000 liters of barley. We've got 34,000 liters of canola, which is not a lot, but it's decent still. 63,000 of wheat, which is fine. Can you imagine when great demand comes, we will be able to make almost, I would say, more than $200,000 from barley. $200,000. When is it gonna come? When is this weird great demand is gonna come? Alright, our harvester and cruise control are gonna work this field just fine. Then one thing I wanna do is I wanna start my mowing process. Alright, this is my favorite tractor on this farm, Puma. It is incredibly powerful and I'm just loving it so far. Alright, another suggestion, you know what I wanna do? I wanna sell my round baler and I wanna do my bales with the square one. I will be needing silage, of course, but there is a mod which I can actually introduce into this farm which allows me to create silage out of square bales. How amazing is that? That would be just ideal. So that's exactly what I'm gonna be doing. I think I'm gonna sell my round baler. We will not be needing it. Alright, this is gonna work much better. This is gonna work much better with the trailer or any other heavy equipment. It's gonna help our stereo here. Let's park it in this little neat garage, which I love. This is decent. Let's park. Stop the engine. And yeah, the only thing that is left for us to do is to purchase our mowers. And my favorite ones, of course, are these Coon mowers. Huh. Although, you know what? Let's go ahead and purchase them. I don't think we have any kind of mowers, do we? This one here, oh my gosh, it annoys the hell out of me. Sell. I don't even want to see it in game. This one is fine. I'm loving it. I love that we have this mixing wagon. I'm love. Ooh, we even have the tedder. So that is amazing. We have this. Bales. Yes, I remember. I actually bought the. Oh my gosh, and it is round. So I was planning to use round baler. That is sad. That is very sad. Actually, you know what? We may have to use our round baler because we just cannot afford to buy another one. Or can we? I might sell it. It's not big of an investment. How much is it? Let's see. How much did we buy it for? That's the main question. Where is it? Baling technology. There you go. We bought it for 24,000. That's not big of a deal, I'd say, if we sell it for 25 less. I think you can sell it for 75% of its original value at the shop over there. So we won't lose a lot. This is the only one. This one costs 45,000. Wow. Damn it. In order to afford everything I want, we have to sell our barley without great demand, I'm afraid. So yeah, we've got our IT runner here as well, which we might use. Alright, I won't be buying any additional bale collector unless I hear what you think, guys. Because I want to know what you think about this current situation. What should I go for? Should I stay with my round baler and sell the square one? Or should I buy the square one and buy that mod that allows us... Basically, it's the same mod as this one, but it will allow the bale wrapper to pack hay in foil so they can ferment into silage, right? So not the round one, it's going to be the square one. That would be interesting to know. In today's episode, though, we will have to buy our mowers. That is out of the question. We're just going ahead and purchasing them. We still have 21,000, so that is not bad. The only thing that is left for us to do is to detect them, and they are all the way over there. Too far. Too far. Alrighty. Now, let's start the tractor. We've spent a bunch of money today. Yes, I know. We've spent a bunch of money. But we have mowers, which we can use finally. Yeah, T6 somehow found a way to bump into the corner. What? This is gonna look awkward, guys, but I have no other way to connect my rear mowers. I don't think I will be resetting them in the future, because it is just amazingly stupid. Yes, it's fine, now it worked. Alright, now our case is ready to work with the mowers. By the way, that's the only tractor that can work with them. I don't think we will mow in this episode though. It's been long enough, I've been preparing everything, talking too much. So in the next episode on this farm, we will be mowing the fields for sure. I promised it for a lot of episodes, I know. But the good side of it is that we're gonna mow everything. We will collect grass instantaneously over there, and we will feed our cows as well as our sheep at the same time. How awesome is that? We're gonna have wool production. What am I talking about? What cows? I was planning to buy beef and sheep to raise them. So, damn it, another thing to consider. We already have cows and sheep, so might as well feed them as well, right? Huh, we've got two fields, so I think I can afford it. So there is gonna be a huge work in the future, guys, to feed everything. Feed our cows, feed our sheep, feed our future cattle. And that's it, I guess. We will be parking our tractor somewhere not too far from the fields. And I love the way that here you've gotta sell milk yourself. It doesn't sell automatically, even though you've gotta invest into tanker. Still, it is much better than just automatic selling. I don't know, I feel like it. It gives you more control over your farm. Alright, this is gonna be our starting point in the... What? You kidding me? Let's just trick you into doing this then. Alright, I tricked you. Anyways, this is gonna be the starting point for the next episode. In the next episode on our Old Ridge farm though, we've got plenty of things to do, and the next episode is gonna be on our Old Ridge farm. So in two episodes of Farming Simulator, we are gonna have mowing. Well, I already told you what we're gonna do, and I like how everything is parked here neatly. Everything is waiting for its turn, and yeah, it is amazing how my horseplay is working with auto combine, no problems at all. I'm not bumping into anything like too much, although we've bumped once, nothing crucial. And yeah, the only thing we need to wait for is great demand, buy ourselves all the necessary things for this farm, and we're set to go. We are set. One crucial thing we need is the tractor, of course. We are lacking one, just one powerful tractor is enough, and we're set. How amazing is that? Alright, but that's gonna be it for this episode, ladies and gentlemen. Don't forget to let me know in the comments below what you think. And as usual, live like there is no tomorrow. Bye-bye.